हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द जीरोज एंड देयर कोफिशिएंट ऑफ लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल एंड क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल इन आवर अर्लियर क्लासेस. तो लेट अस कंटिन्यू इन दिस ऑर्डर. टुडे आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट द रिलेशनशिप बिटवीन द जीरोज एंड कोफिशिएंट ऑफ ए क्यूबिक पॉलीनोमियल. ओके, so everyone look here. If alpha, beta and gamma are the zeros of the cubic polynomial ax cube plus bx square plus cx plus d, then we have find a relation between their zeros and the coefficient. Okay, so let us discuss about them. Which is the first relationship between the zeros and their coefficient of a cubic polynomial? So everyone look here. The first relationship between zeros and coefficient is alpha plus beta plus gamma is equal to minus b upon a. Okay. In other words, we can say that sum of zeros of a cubic polynomial is always equal to minus coefficient of x square upon coefficient of x cube. Okay, because you look here, the coefficient of x square is b and the coefficient of x cube is a. So we can write it in this form, because b is the coefficient of x square and a is the coefficient of x cube. So this is the first relationship between zeros and coefficient of cubic polynomial. Okay, next, number second is alpha into beta into gamma is always equal to d upon a. Minus d upon a. This is the second relationship between zeros and coefficient of a cubic polynomial, which is expressed as product of zeros, because alpha into beta into gamma, and we know that alpha, beta, gamma are the zeros of the polynomial, so it is also written as product of zeros is equal to minus constant term upon coefficient of x cube. Okay, so this is the basic formula for the relationship between zeros and coefficient. This is the first relationship and this is the second relation. Okay, and in number first it is known as sum of zeros, and number second is known as product of zero. There is one more relationship between zeros and coefficient in cubic polynomial, but we have know that in quadratic polynomial there is only two relationship. First is sum of zeros and second is product of zero. But in case of cubic polynomial there is one more relationship between zeros and its coefficient. So everyone look here. Relationship number third. It is written as alpha into beta plus beta into gamma plus gamma into alpha is equal to c upon a. Okay, so this is equal to c upon a. or it is also known as C means coefficient of x and A means coefficient of x. So it is also written another form means coefficient of x upon coefficient of x cube. Okay, so this is the third relationship between the zeros and coefficient of a cubic polynomial. So friends, you always learn it. Okay, next we will try to solve some examples and questions which is related on relationship between zeros and coefficient of a linear, cubic and quadratic polynomial. Okay, now look here. So everyone, look at the question number first from exercise 2.2. This is the first question. In this question, first you find the zeros of the following quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between the zeros and the coefficient. Question number first. This is x square minus 2x plus, minus 8. Okay? And number second is (4x)² - (4s+1). Okay, friends? Everyone, look at the question number first from exercise 2.2. In this question, first you find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and then you establish the relationship between their zeros and coefficient. Okay, now question number first, it is a quadratic polynomial because its degree is 2. Okay, so first of all we find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. Okay, while we finding the factor of this polynomial, we use the prime factorization method for the quadratic polynomial. So everyone, be careful. The given polynomial is (x²−2x−8). Okay. Now it can be written as (x²−2x). At the place of 2, we write (-4x+2x) - 8. Because we know that the prime factor of A is equal to 4 × 2. 4 × 2 = 8, and 4 - 2 = the number of coefficient x. This means जब हम (x²−2x−8) का प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन करते हैं तो 8 में जो फैक्टर है वो 4 × 2 होंगे, क्योंकि ये वो फैक्टर है जो बिल्कुल सूटेबल फैक्टर है इस क्वेश्चन के अकॉर्डिंग, क्योंकि 4 × 2 = 8 एंड 4 - 2 = द कोफिशियंट ऑफ x विच इज -3. सो दिस इज द प्रॉपर फैक्टर ऑफ 8. सो एट द प्लेस ऑफ -2x वी पुट -4x + 2x. क्लियर? नाउ by making grouping or by make a group, we have x minus 4 out of x plus, in these two terms we get 2 as a common factor and x minus 4. Okay, now again we find x minus 4 as a common factor in both terms, then it is equal to the product of two factors, which is x minus 4 and x plus 2. तो इस तरह से हम इस क्वाड्रेटिक पॉलीनोमियल के प्राइम फैक्टराइजेशन करके इसके दो फैक्टर्स यहाँ पे फाइंड कर देते हैं. ओके, तो ये हमारा फैक्टर है x माइनस फोर एंड x प्लस टू. और अगर हमें यहाँ पे इनकी वैल्यू फाइंड करना है तो हम x और x प्लस टू और x माइनस फोर को जीरो से कंपेयर करके इसकी वैल्यू हम फाइंड कर सकते हैं. तो फाइनली वी है x इक्वल टू फोर एंड x इक्वल टू माइनस टू. These are two factors of this quadratic polynomial. Okay, and now we find the relationship between their zeros and coefficients. The first relation is known as sum of zeros, which is equal to minus b on a. Okay, friends, sum of zeros. Here are two zeros, 4 and minus 2. So first of all, we have these two zeros, 4 and minus 2. And on the right side, we put the value of b and a according to the given polynomial. Okay? And we know that b is the coefficient of x and a is the coefficient of x square. So, on putting the value of their coefficient, we get 4 plus minus 2 is equal to minus 2 upon 1. Okay? And we know that 2 times negative number is as positive, so it is equal to plus 2, and here 4 minus 2 is equal to plus 2. So everyone, we look here, the left hand side and the right hand side are equal. So this is the verification of the relation between zeros and coefficients. Okay, this is the first relation. Now we will find the second relationship between the zeros and coefficients, and we know that the second relationship is known as product of zeros, and it is equal to c upon a. Okay, now put the value of zeros and coefficient of x square and x. Okay, so we get plus 4 into minus 2, because 4 and minus 2 are two zeros on the given polynomial. So first of all we multiply them, and then we put the value of c and a from the polynomial, and we know that c, which is the coefficient, which is the constant term, and in this question the constant term is minus 8, and a, which is the coefficient of x square. This means, as you can see here, the coefficient of x square is equal to 1, so it is equal to minus 8 upon 1, and finally we get minus 8. And on the left side, plus 4 into minus 2 is also equal to minus 8. Here we obtain the left hand side is equal to right hand side. So in this case we can say that this is the verification of the relationship between zeros and coefficient of a quadratic polynomial. Okay students, so similarly question number 1, you can also establish the relationship between the another quadratic polynomial which is given in question number 2, 3 and so on. Okay, and students, now you can
try to solve exercise 2.2 question number 1 and 2. Okay, thank you.